Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to watch our course on polity and many other courses, my dear friend. Today we're gonna see about budget in the polity class. This is class number 24. Kindly watch our playlist so that you get all the topics that are required for your competitive exams to the standard of UPSC and Group 1. For all competitive exams, my dear friend, we shall see in detail. You have many doubts in recent time, like what is interim budget and vote on account and many other things, how our budget is to be released. Actually, our finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman gonna release a budget, and what, how they gonna release the budget, everything you have a doubt before seeing that budget. This class makes you much more comfortable and clear enough to understand politically the budget, how the procedure and everything happens. As usual, we start our class with a good motivational quote. My dear friend, remember this, the 6 rules to be happy in your life: never hate anyone, friends, love is everything, and also don't worry, whatever happens happens for your good only. Live simple. Simplicity is the best way to make you happy, and also expect a little from others, never expect from any others, my dear friend. Everything is inside you, just satisfy with what you have. Give a lot, you have a lot of love, expression, everything, give it to everyone. Always keep smiling. The smile in your face keeps you much more comfortable, and also keeps people around you also more comfortable. So just keep smiling, my dear friend. Now we shall move on to our topic. What is budget? As usual, simple thing, let me link it to, my dear friends. If you are living in your home, what is your home? It is a simple home. Who is your budget manager? Here in our home, finance minister is our mom. Dad earns money and mom maintains that money. How does she maintain? Whenever he gets a monthly income, for the month she plans. What does she plans? How much income she gets? Based on the income, she keeps her expenditure in limit. Like, she must buy for food, and also expenses for health, and also expenses for your daily lifestyle, and also recreations, movies, dress, everything. Every part of your life is scheduled by your mom. She schedules everything, and also she keeps it for savings for further use also. So this needs a plan. Budget is not a concept which we plan for whole nation also. It is a simple plan which we plan for our small homes also. But this is constitutional, that is not constitutional, that's the difference. Now we shall move on to budget. Now you know what is there in budget. You know, receipts, how much money we get by the government, and also how much money we expenditure, we spend by the government, and also here it is the total government's receipts and expenditure. One thing you must know in our exams, that Constitution doesn't use the word budget anywhere. They just simply say that annual financial statement. Remember this word, annual financial statement means budget. There is no any word called budget mentioned in your Constitution. That in Article 112 says in detail about annual financial statement. Okay, now India's or our financial year, when does it start? Our financial year starts from April 1st and ends by March 31st. This is much more crucial, and many things will be answered by this. Okay, you remember this financial year, this plays a crucial role, so that only before the financial year only we release our budget, so make our expenses ample amount and satisfying to our financial needs of that year. Okay, my dear friend, next we can see budget. If you are gonna release a budget of 2019, what are all the things that are present in our budget? Let me explain in detail. This is much more important. If you are presenting this year 2019 budget, you have budget estimates of this upcoming year, which means 2019 has started, we didn't finish it. 2019 financial year starts from 2019 April 1st and ends by March 31st of 2020. So for that financial year we are preparing budget. So we estimate the budget, how much we gonna spend for the further year. And next we have a revised estimate of a previous year, which means 2018 to 2019 we have a revised estimate, not a complete estimates, but here for that before year, which means at 2017-18 we have actual expenditure, which means out of all the expenditure we spent everything in detail. Why we are having a revised estimates? Remember one thing, my dear friend, our budget preparation starts, actually let me tell you one thing, budget has 4 stages. One is preparation stage, and also presentation stage, and next we get approval stage. After presentation, we need all the bills and appropriation and financial bills to be approved. After that, our budget has been approved. Then we have implementation stage. These are all the four stages we have in our budget. And also in this preparation stage, our budget starts preparation by last year only. Today, 2019, we're gonna submit our budget. By September 2018 itself, our budget preparation starts. So that only we have a revised estimates of 2018-19, but actual expenditure we get only by of 2017 and 18. This is what we have. So now we shall see in detail. See, remember this of 1 year, 1 year, which means you minus by 1 year, you get all these things. The budget contains three things: budget estimates, revised estimate, and actual expenditure. What are all those things I had explained to you now here? And you have estimates of revenue and capital receipts. You have revenue and capital receipts, and also ways and means of raising our revenue, which are all the ways we choose to raise our revenue so that only our government can run successfully. And also estimates of expenditure. We don't know how much we spend or expenditure for the further year. So we estimate. Then here the closing year, which means 2018-19 is not yet closed. The closing year financial year details will be having, like economic survey and these things will be released previously. And then we have, if you have a deficit in money, why it is deficit, those things you must mention as a reason. And also if it is surplus, why it is surplus, those reasons also must be explained. And next we get economic and financial policy of the coming year. As usual, you know, the next year economic and financial policies will be present here. Hope these are all the things that are present in our budget. What are all the things that we contain in our budget? And next we shall see here. We used to have two budgets separately, my dear friend. One is railway budget, other is general budget. Now this railway budget has been merged into general budget. 2017 is a crucial year because it has two changes. Railway budget merged with general budget. And one more thing is our general budget has been brought precise, which means we brought 1 month yearly. What is that reason also I'll be explaining in a general budget. Now let me tell you here, railway budget is released by railway ministry separately for railways. It is proposed in 1921 according to the Acworth committee recommendations. By 1924 our first railway budget was proposed. For 92 years since still 2016 we are having railway budget separately, but after 2016 that was our final railway budget. Then in 2017 we had railway budget to be mixed with, which means merged with general budget. Next, why do we have a railway budget? Actually, this is an era of British rule, my dear friend, because they had railway budget separately. They had much more income through railways. So they must spend all the income they got through railways for the further development of the railways. That was the plan. And the railways were most beneficial for the Britishers. So to maintain the flexibility in railway finance, to improve the business approach in railway policy, and also secure the stability. Yeah, obviously the revenue that they got through railways must be spent to the railways. And next you can see, to keep the profits for their own development. Yeah, this ministry is getting high profit, so we just keep for their own benefits. And also so that only railway department has been a most successful trusted department for a long duration of time. Everybody feel pride that they are working in the railways like that. It is because of their separate railway budget and allowance, everything they were getting individually. Now we shall see constitutionally what are all the things that were said about our budget. What are all the things that are given in our budget? Let us see in detail here. President, every financial year he announces, which means both the houses, he gives the estimated receipts and expenditures of Government of India of that year. One more thing, this budget, you know, when it is to be stated, which means when it is to be presented, the date is fixed by whom? The date of presentation of the budget is fixed by President. And one more thing here, no demand of grant, demand for grant. You know what is demand, what is grant? Demand means I am asking you something. Actually, I'm running this channel. To run this channel, I need some amount of money from the administration. I demand them. So when they approve it, it becomes a grant. You will understand now clearly, my dear friend. That is the thing. So every demand of grant must be with president recommendation. So without his recommendations, no demand of grants can be proposed. Because demand of grants means it is similar to the money bill. And also, what is Consolidated Fund of India? Whatever the expenditure we do in our budget is taken from the Consolidated Fund of India. So no money from this Consolidated Fund of India cannot be taken without the appropriation bill. Yeah, appropriation bill means here you will understand whatever the paisa, if you need to take 1 rupee also, you need an appropriation bill to take the money from Consolidated Fund of India. This proves the accountability to the parliament, which means a Lok Sabha mainly. And also no money bill, you know about money bills, no money bill is passed without the recommendation of president. And the money bill means it actually released only, presented only in Lok Sabha first. And also money bill means why do you need a money bill in budget? Because in budget you will be proposing a new taxes. So if you are imposing any new taxes, you must introduce a money bill. So imposing of taxes is the main purpose where you take a money bill in our budget. And also no tax is levied or collected except by the law. Here law is much more important. New tax revisions or new tax collections, everything must be taken within the law provisions. Here one more statement, many of you confused during this prelims questions or many times, so that I am mentioning this word. Parliament can reduce or abolish tax but cannot increase the tax. This word indicates one thing, my dear friend. Here levying tax is whose power? Never one thing, my dear friends, never think that parliament can levy a tax. Parliament is a body. Who levies the tax? Only executive. Executive is a person who can levy a tax and who can increase the tax. So this parliament, what does that do? Parliament just approves it, either approving or disapproving. So that is the statement here provided. Parliament can reduce a tax or abolish a tax through that approval procedure, but they cannot introduce a new tax or increase the existing tax. So parliament is a approving body. That is the statement here, explains us clearly. And next, in houses, important bill conditions we can see here. In money bill, if you are seeing this money bill and financial bill of type 1, only introduced in Lok Sabha, not in Rajya Sabha. Remember this, regarding a money bill or financial bill of type 1, as usual I had said in our previous class, it is only related to Lok Sabha and not to Rajya Sabha. And also if you are considering to Rajya Sabha, vote on demands of grant. As I said, if I am asking for money, it is demand, and if they approve and give me money, that is grant. Now both are the same. Here no power for voting in a demands of grants. Rajya Sabha has zero power, my dear friend, and also only the Lok Sabha has the maximum power on demands of grant. And also here Rajya Sabha, regarding money bill, it has only few power, which means a little power, only 14 days it can hold the money bill, nothing more than that can happen. And next you can see here what are all the things present here. In Consolidated Fund of India, we have two types of estimated expenditure separately. So the expenses are also compared in two types. One is charged expenditure, other is made on Consolidated Fund of India. Here charged and uncharged also you can see, uncharged otherwise non-charged, whatever the thing you can understand, but these both are opposite. So here charged means what? Made on Consolidated Fund of India means what you will be studying here, my dear friends. Before that, see here, budget differentiate expenditure of revenue account and other accounts. What is revenue account? The day-to-day income we get to the government is called as a revenue account, and other type of capital income, everything we consider separately. And here now let me explain you. Charged expenditure of Consolidated Fund of India is not voted. This is much more important. In your prelim statement based question, you will get confused. Charged expenditure on Consolidated Fund of India is not voted. It is only discussed in the budget. And also the expenditure made on Consolidated Fund of India, otherwise uncharged expenditure we can say, or non-charged expenditure we can say, whatever the thing, it is only voted. See here, it is only non-charged expenditure is only voted in the parliament. Now let me tell you what is charged expenditure and why it is not voted. So let us see charged expenditure in or on Consolidated Fund of India. Let me explain this, my dear friends. Emoluments and expenditure of president. Remember one thing, the expenditure and emoluments and salaries of president and important persons in our government or executive, if they are charged in, they actually, as usually they will be charged from Consolidated Fund of India. if they are taken into vote every time, it will become an issue. And also it is must and should that their salary must be allocated. So there must not be voting system. If it is rejected, the government will be dissolved. So at that situation, it will be a complexity. So reduce that complexity. It is fixed that this charged expenditure can never be voted. You can discuss, which means you can increase the expenditure or reduce the expenditure. That can be discussed but never voted. So here the emoluments and expenditure of president, salaries, allowance of chairman of Rajya Sabha, deputy chairman of Rajya Sabha, speaker, deputy speaker, you know, the chairman of Rajya Sabha means, you know, he is the vice president. And next, salary, allowance and pensions of judges of Supreme Court. This thing you must be remembering or seeing carefully. Salary, allowance and pensions of judges of Supreme Court is charged from Consolidated Fund of India. But when you come to the high courts, only the pensions of the judges of high court, remember this, only pensions of the judges of high court is taken from Consolidated Fund of India. So what about this salary and allowance? Salary plus allowance of high court judges, what is it? What happened to that? Question yourself. It is taken from State Consolidated Fund, which means Consolidated Fund of State. So concerned state will be providing the salaries and allowances of high court judges. So you will be clear that this statement will make you trouble in your exam. So this thing you must not make mistake. Next, salary, allowance and pensions of CAG chairman, UPSC chairman and UPSC members, and also administrative expenses of SC, which means Supreme Court, administrative expenses of CAG, UPSC, whatever the administrative expenses of these organizations is also charged from the Consolidated Fund of India. Next, government of India will be having debt, those debts, loans they had taken, interest we must repay, everything is charged from the Consolidated Fund of India, which means this expenditure must and should be collected and done over. And next, you can see any sum that government announces or award for the any court or tribunal, those things also must be provided by the government. And next, any expenditure charged, which means a parliament decides this expenditure must be charged expenditure. Like that, if a parliament decides any new expenditure, that too can be included in the charged expenditure. Till now, these are all present in a charged expenditure. Whatever apart from these expenditures is considered as the made on, which means expenditure made on Consolidated Fund of India or uncharged expenditure. Now our budget. Now our budget is introduced in our Lok Sabha. How? On which stages it goes through? We shall see here. It goes through 6 stages. Let me show them clearly. First, the presentation of the budget. Now we present the budget, finance minister presents the budget, and next we have a general discussion. Actually, before the presentation of budget, there will be a, before 10 days there will be a halwa ceremony. Everybody will be eating halwa. I will tell you about that in last slide. Next, after presentation of budget, general discussion will be taking place. After general discussion, all the budget profiles will be considered, detailedly scrutinized by departmental standing committees, everything. And then go for voting on demands of grant. After voting, we pass our appropriation bill. And then appropriation of bill, there is a passing of financial bill. So what is the difference between appropriation bill, finance bill? I'll be making you clear. Appropriation bill is to take money from Consolidated Fund of India, and also finance bill is to changes in tax. So these things, simple words I'm saying, in detail I'll be providing in next slides. Here, after general discussion, we pass vote on account. See, vote on account, what is it? Vote on account, I'll be explaining that also, what is its importance also here. These are all the important concepts where you miss, and also you'll be having a possibility of making mistakes. So I'm mentioning here, in this vote on here, voting of demands of grants is, you know, here we pass cut motions. So every stage, few crucial things are there. Why I'm mentioning earlier is, after when I'm taking in these slides, when I'm going through there, you must be much more clear. Next, here we can see presentation of budget. We present our budget in two types, railway budget and general budget. That was until 2016. From 2017 it has been changed. I'll be also saying that too. Here, railway budget is given by Railway Minister and it is present in Lok Sabha in third week of February. Here, general budget is presented by Finance Minister with President's approval. And next, here Lok Sabha, it is present in Lok Sabha. Both the budgets are present in Lok Sabha. Last week of February. Let me compare here, because this is also a possibility for your exams. third week of February is railway budget, and last week of February is general budget. So which budget comes earlier? Railway budget comes earlier than general budget. But now after 2017, everything changed. What changed? Now railway budget is merged with general budget, and from 2017 the budget has been preponed. Preponed means from last week of February to, they had brought it to first week, first February, which means first February itself we will be having our budget from 2017. Okay, why it has been preponed? Wait and watch, I will be explaining that also when time comes, because here if I explain you will not get a clear idea. In next slides further it is waiting for your explanation. Next here we can see budget speech. Who gives the budget speech? Finance minister gives the budget speech. So remember that. And here he explains about two parts, which is about the bill and everything details, and also financial conditions of the country and for the future how he has planned. Everything he will be giving in the financial speech, which means a budget speech. And then he will be giving first at Lok Sabha, then later he moves on to the Rajya Sabha, and that also he presents our budget here in Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha. While the presentation of budget, there is only discussion goes on, but no votes on grants or demand, votes on demands of grants will be happening. So during the presentation stage, nothing happens, just our finance minister presents our budget. Okay, you know what happens in the presentation stage. Now we go to the discussion stage. After presentation of our house, which means our presentation of budget, our houses takes a 3 to 4 days gap. After a few days gap of presentations, the Lok Sabha, they discuss as a whole. So now they sit together and they discuss what is this bill, and everybody discusses, and also they question only main principles, what is the purpose of the bill and important thoughts of the bill, everything. And during this discussion, they don't use any cut motion or no vote on house or finance. Only the finance minister replies to the discussion. Okay, everybody starts asking, oh finance minister, what is that, what is this, why you are bringing this one, what is the use to the nation. So everything they will be questioning and he will be answering politely. This is what happens in general discussion. If this is over, an overview discussion is over and general discussion is over, after that what they will be doing, they will be sending, which means general discussion. After general discussion, our houses will be adjourned, will be taking a break of 3 to 4 weeks. In these 3 to 4 weeks, all the budget sheets will be printed and copies will be given to every departmental committees, which means departmental standing committees will be there. 24 departmental standing committees are present. In these 24 departmental standing committees, they will be sending it to every committee. Every committee clearly examines, detailedly discuss, and also all the demands of grants. What is demands of grants? As I said, I am SPV, running SPV Education World. Here, if someone is a higher authority to me, what I say, to run this channel, I need some expenses. I will show, and this is my ministry, this is the department. Okay, rather than that, I will give you a better example. Here, our mom is our finance minister at home. She will be calculating all the expenditure, which means she needs for a house rent, she needs for other food, she needs for games, she needs for school fees, tuition fees, everything. She divides all the money requirements and she demands everything. So if you consider everything as a separate ministry, like defense ministry, health ministry, education ministry, HRD ministry, so separate ministries are there. So every ministry needs the money. So every ministry demands the money for the financial. So okay, this is financial 2019-20, I must spend this much amount of money. So they ask the government. So when they ask the government, that demands are being voted, which means that is discussed. Either the ministry is required this much amount of money, how they gonna spend. So concerned ministry is consulted and detailed reports are prepared on them. So every concerned ministry is studied over and their reports are prepared. Now you'll be having a detail. Now 3 stages gone. This stage is much more crucial. Now you know every department report has been prepared. So based on the report of standing committees, departmental standing committees, all the bills has been voted. So now I'm asking, so if I am asking for money, that is a demand. If you approve the money, that is a grant. So now in Lok Sabha, these demands are taken. Here Rajya Sabha has no power on demands of grant. Dog, I said. So okay, dogs live in only Lok Sabha, not in Rajya Sabha. Remember like that, no issues. Here our Rajya Sabha doesn't have power in demands of grants. Here, ministry-wise, they take separate demands of grants, and also all the demands are voted. Whenever the demand is voted, it becomes the grant. Now, you know, when demand becomes the grant, if it is voted, it becomes a grant. And next, if you take the budget, it has two expenditure, charged expenditure and non-charged expenditure. Now, let me tell you, charged expenditure is never voted. So, vote and demand for grants is not for the charged expenditure. It is only for non-charged expenditure, which are to be gone for voting or voted. Now, you know, after this voting, there are motions to reduce the demands of grants. Certain ministries would have asked a certain amount of money. If you are dissatisfied with those amounts, you can pass the cut motions. Here, you know, cut motion also is a only phenomena in our Lok Sabha. It cannot be passed in Rajya Sabha. It is of three kinds. Let me tell you what are all that. Now, policy cut motion. Now, if you consider what is policy cut motion, it reduces the demand by rupees 1. Here, see here, like putting a rupee to your beggar. Here, they reduce the policy amount. I'm gonna introduce new policy. For that policy, I'm saying I need 1000 crores. You like sarcastically reduce my amount by rupees 1. What does that mean? You are not approving mine. So, it indicates a disapproval of the policy. So, if you're passing a policy cut motion, it indicates that you are disapproving the policy. So you must be advocating an alternative policy. So you must introduce an alternative policy if you're introducing a policy cut motion. Then what is economic cut motion? Economic cut motion means it reduces the demand by specific amount, which means a certain amount you got planned to reduce it. And also economy can be affected due to it. Now you understand, if you're passing the economic cut motion, obviously you're gonna affect the economic condition of that policy or of that ministry. So it is to curtail the work purpose of it. Next, if you take the token cut motion means here you reduce the demand by rupees 100. So if you're reducing by a certain amount, which means rupees 100, then you are showing some sort of specific grievance, which means there is a problem in that policy, so kindly go and solve it. It is a responsibility of Government of India to act on that. So to show the uncomfortability and to make them take an action regarding that grievance, token cut motion can be passed. So we shall see now what is the qualities of this cut motion. See what are the three conditions. Three conditions we had seen, that policy, economic and token cut motions. Now we shall see the qualities of it. Simple thing, my dear friend. You must be taking one demand only. So separately for each demand, you must be passing the cut motion, and you must be clearly expressing that no argument must be present over there, and also defamatory statement should not be present there, and also your decision must be confined to the specific matter. So only a particular matter you must be discussion in the cut motions, and there are no amendments or repealing of the existing law present in this cut motion. Also, you must not introduce a cut motion apart from the union government. So something under the governance of union government or under the cover of union government, you must be taking into the consideration. And one more thing, let me tell you, my friend, charged expenditure. See here, demands of grant docs is only for demands of grants is only for non-charged expenditure. So obviously there is no charged expenditure demands of grants. If there is no demands of grants voted, obviously there is no cut motion also. So for charged expenditure, if you see something called cut motion, it is not there. So because this, you must not get confused. This is important, my dear friend, because you will be making mistake here. Charged expenditure doesn't have cut motion. Why? You understood that because demands of grant is not there for charged expenditure. Next, we can see here, no matter under court's surveillance, if something is taken under the courts or court's issue is running, so that matters you should not take for cut motions, and also privileges should not be questioned in the cut motion. Next, you must not discuss a decision, which means in this session I had took a decision, so again you must not pass the cut motion or take a discussion of that decision, because once the decision taken is final, so again you must not raise the same thing again and again. And also something related to trivial matters and important issues, no cut motion can be passed. So now you understood what are all the things that are important for your cut motion. See here, every statement plays an important role. So if you read also, you may get certain times missed over. So you listen it carefully, my dear friends. And also next we can see what is the significance of our cut motion. Here, specific demands of grant, every specific demands of grant, we are taking it and discussing it in detail. So it creates a much more specific discussion. And next, it is also shows the responsibility of our government. You can see here, if you are more approving a policy cut motion means you are disapproving. So here you are showing the responsibility of government. If token cut means you are showing your grievance. And also it also indicates the parliamentary confidence. One thing remember friend, if a government have its confidence, no cut motion can be passed. If cut motions are passed, then the parliament there is a question mark of its confidence. So it is also there is a chance of creating a dissolution of the Lok Sabha also. So it is a much more crucial thing. Let me tell you what is guillotine. One thing, my dear friend, before understanding guillotine, let me tell you one simple thing. Here I am having 10 chapters, 1 year, which means 365 days to exam. What you will be doing? All the 364 days, you will be simply sitting and reading first chapter only. Whenever you start the book, you read first chapter, again read the first chapter, again read the first chapter. So you never open the book called 2 to 10 chapters. So all the remaining chapters you never open. Now the D-Day had come over, 365th day, the same day you are having exam. So what you do, either you went to class or not, you know the topics or not, you have read it or not, you just within a 1 day like Robo 2.0, you just finish everything, which means all the 9 chapters within second, without reading or without understanding, you just revise everything and go for your exam. This is called guillotine. Now you understand at the last minute rush. Now you understand a last minute rush is called as a guillotine. Now let me tell you, for voting all the demands, you have 26 days to pass all the voting, all the demands. Now what do you do? Guillotine means what? So all the bills, if you have 60 ministries demands, 40 ministries has been completed and now 20 are remaining. So only 1 day remaining. So the last day, speaker takes all the 20 bills or to all the 20 demands and put to vote directly. There is no discussion whether it is discussed or not. He disposes them all. So at one go, all the demands whichever not yet discussed also will be gone for voting. Such situation is called guillotine. Now you understand guillotine means what? Last minute rush. So without a discussion, they will be passing all the demands into vote. That is called as guillotine. Now you understand what is it here. Now passing of appropriation bill. Let me tell you one thing. Constitutionally, appropriation bill has a much more importance. Let me tell you what is constitution says that no money, not even a rupee can be taken away from consolidated fund of India. So this is the fund where India spends all its amount for all the expenditure, budgetary expenditure. So from that, if you want to take a money, 1 rupee also, you need an appropriation made by the law. So appropriation bill is compulsory that you need to take your amount from consolidated fund of India. So you understand what is the importance of appropriation bill. It, for whatever the grants voted in the Lok Sabha, you had seen the votes on grants, and then whatever the expenditure charged on the consolidated fund of India, here charged or uncharged, whatever the thing that you need to take the amount from your consolidated fund of India, you need to pass a appropriation bill. Okay friend, now you can see here in the appropriation bill, what does the thing that cannot happen? No amendments can be proposed. So appropriation bill is as simple as that, only approving. So here president gives his assent. When president gives his assent, this appropriation bill will be converting into appropriation act. Now let me take you one thing. Here, what is the thing? Budget has started. I presented the budget. General discussion took place. After general discussion, we had taken for committees, departmental committees. After DC, we went to votes on demand of grants, DOGS. Okay, we went to votes on demands of grant. Then we come to appropriation bill. Now you would be understanding, if I am introducing the bill in last day, which means last week of February, what it takes after presenting general discussion, then departmental committee scrutiny, everything after that, to pass the appropriation bill, it will be taking April last week or May. This is the time it will be taking to pass the appropriation bill. But what did our constitution said? Our constitution said that not even a rupee can be taken or money cannot be taken without the appropriation bill. But what is here? My financial year start from April 1st. So by April 1st, to start my business and run my financial year, I must be having money. So my appropriation bill is taking time when it is to be passed by April last week. So here comes the confusion. Here rises the problem. When such problem rises, so we introduced vote on account. Here government needs the money of the financial by April 1st to function, but appropriation bill is taking time till April last week or May. So to that only we introduce vote on account. What is vote on account? See here, in a government or some, now in private company you are working, you are getting a salary of something called as a 12,000, okay, 12,000 salary you are getting. But now you need to urgent need, you need you are having a fever, so you must be paying fees. What you must be go to doctor and you need urgent expense. That time what you do, you just call your office head or your owner and ask him to give certain amount of money in advance so that he can take it away from his salary. So in your salary you ask 1/6 amount. 1/6 amount means what? He'll be giving 2,000. So you take the 2,000 and take care of health and everything, good condition of you. Then whenever you get your money, you will be deducted that amount and given to you. So you have a clear clarity that advance. So it is like taking something money in advance. That is what you called as vote on account. Vote on account is passed after general discussion stage. Here you say second stage is general discussion stage. In the general discussion stage, you take money in advance. So there only you vote on. You take vote on account, which means a granted for 2 months. In a, to fulfill the short term needs of this 2 months, you get your money through vote on account. You get a 1/6 of total estimation. You know what is the total estimation? If it is 12,000 crores, you get 1/6, 2,000 crores you get. So this is what called as vote on account. This is what advance in estimate expenditure. I'm estimating this much expenditure for the year, but it is taking for the length for appropriation bill, so that I take it in advance. Now let me tell you one more thing, why our budget has been advanced. Now you know, my dear friend, our budget is being submitted from February 1st. Previously, last week of February, which means last week of February means it will be from March 1st, they will be submitting. But they preponed by 1 month. Why? This is the reason, my dear friend. Here, if they prepone and if they introduce February 1st, by April 1st itself, they will be getting the appropriation bill to be passed sooner. So then, by the financial, they need not go for vote on account. Obviously, they can directly spend the money and also all the problems will be solved. This is why they preponed our budget. So you will be understanding clearly. Even you read 1,000 times, you cannot understand. Now you will be understand what is vote on account and why it is preponed. Remember one thing, vote on account is different from interim budget. Many confused with interim budget and vote on account. Here vote on account, you just only see the expenditure side. Here estimated expenditure, what the year you're gonna spend for as an expenditure. In advance you take certain amount for that expenditure. Everything will be voted in appropriation bill. Nothing a big deal. Okay, now you understand. And last slide I will be explaining interim budget, then you understand, because now if I explain you'll be linking both. Never you should link vote on account and interim budget. Both has major difference, but recent days newspapers has made you confused because of linking both and saying you. Here we can see here, passing a financial bill. What is financial bill? Financial bill means it is to propose financial proposal, which means here appropriation bill doesn't take any finance proposals. So financial changes doesn't happen in appropriation bill. So what does this financial bill do? It takes financial proposal of Government of India of the following year. So upcoming year, what are all the finances that you're going to propose? Everything is considered under finance bill. And also tax changes. If you want a tax changes like income side of government, whatever the government income you're going to take, what are new tax proposals, everything you can be introduced through financial bill, as I said earlier. And rejection and reduction of any new tax, because the tax is not a functioning of appropriation bill. Here in exam you will be confusing with financial bill and appropriation bill. I'm making it much more clear here, so be careful while listening. And next, if it is passed, it is similar to the money bill, it is passed in a parliament and also it must be assented within 75 days. So in budget the financial bill must be approved within 75 days. That is the condition they had given. Now other grants in a budget, what are all the grants that you get apart from the normal grants we had seen earlier? Now let me explain supplementary grant. What is supplementary grant? Clearly, my dear friend, be it here, insufficient for a particular service, insufficient amount is there for the current financial year, so that time we get a supplementary grant. So I explained in brief. Now let me detail. This supplementary grant is approved or authorized by Parliament. It is also need a appropriation act for a particular service. If certain service of the current financial year, particular service of the current financial year has insufficient money. So if you are having insufficient money, you need a supplementary grant. So then only you can spend. So it is called as the supplementary grant. Now additional grant. Additional grant means what? You need a, for current financial year, you need an additional expenditure. Now suddenly you brought some new services. If you are bringing some new services which is not given in our budget, see here, some new expenditure that is not present in the budget, then that expenditure is for that expenditure you need a additional grant. Okay, now excess grant. Excess means what? Always more than the what is given. So any service financial year, if it exceeds the grant, you are giving a 1,000 crores, but your expenditure is increasing 1,010 crores or 1,020 crores. So obviously you are exceeding the grant. So remaining amount is voted in Lok Sabha in another financial. So next financial year, this financial they'll take amount approved from Public Accounts of India of the Parliament, and they'll be getting approval from that, and they'll be spent over. But later it will be voted upon. So if you are taking excess amount, that too will be voted in next financial year. Now vote on credit. Remember one thing. What is credit? Credit means what? Credit means something you are taking in advance. You are giving a trust on you so that you can get extra amount so that you can spend it in emergency need. Always credit is a emergency need expenditure. So unexpected demand. If you are getting unexpected demand in a upon the resources available in India, and also it is a indefinite character of service. Here in budget, certain expenditures must not be explained. For example, a secret service is there, and also secret operation is going on, like RAW or some other. For that, you need an expenditure that you cannot be explaining in your budget. So that expenditure is given to executive. For the executive, Lok Sabha gives a blank check. That blank check is called as vote of credit. So it is a advanced money, and also it is for unexpected expenditure. For example, you can see certain situations like war like conditions, that time also you need an unexpected demand or unexpected expenditure. So it is like a blank check given to the executive by the Lok Sabha. If this statement was found, you must be remembering this as a vote of credit, because in UPSC you get a statements like blank check given to executive by Lok Sabha. What is it? It is a vote of credit. So certain statements you get like that, so you must be a bit more careful, my dear. Next we can see here, exceptional grant. What is exceptional grant? Some special purpose is there. So for that special purpose, if you need any money, it is called as exceptional grant, and it is also not a part of current service or also any financial year. So it is a special purpose, so nobody can expect this. So it is a special purpose, so it is exceptional grant, so you cannot accept it. Sorry, you cannot skip it, you must be granting it. That is it. Token grant means what? It is a fund, which means reappropriation. There is a fund in it, but you need to transfer the fund from one ministry to other ministry, and also funds to meet the expenditure of new service. There is some new service, for that you need a money. It will be a grant, like you will be passing a reappropriation of sum of ₹1. So after passing this, the Lok Sabha will be giving an assent to the available fund, because funds are available there only, but you need to transfer it to the other new service that based on the requirement. It is called as a token grant. Now let me tell you, if you are introducing budget in our government, what are all the documents we have? Around we will be having 14 to 15 documents, 16 documents, my dear friend. But in that 15 are common, main, important. In that 15, 4 are given in our constitution, 4 are given in FRBM Act 2003. FRBM Act is Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act. And also other remaining, how much will be 8 and 7. So it may be up and downs. The remaining documents are by the recommendation of Niti Aayog. Let us see what are all the documents. See here, compulsory documents you must be remembering, and also FRBM Act also you must be remembering. Just remember the compulsory documents present in our budget. It is annual financial statement under Article 112, demands of grant under Article 113, Appropriation Bill under Article 114 Class 3, Financial Bill under Article 110 Class A. As I had explained this, all the four concepts clearly, so no issue for you. And next, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act. Based on this, we need to maintain our fiscal balance, and also we must be maintaining our fiscal responsibility, then only we can maintain our standard growth. So macroeconomic framework statement will be having, then financial policy statement framework, where we must be seeing how much income we are getting, how much expenditure we are making, and how much we are backward in our how much balance sheet, budget deficit, everything they'll be seeing through this fiscal policy. Next, medium term fiscal policy statement, medium term expenditure framework statement. Here, expenditure framework statement means in middle of the financial year, you may need certain urgent expenditure. Those are considered are given in this statement. Next, here, recommendations of Niti Aayog. What is Niti Aayog do? It has the provisions of financial bill and also expenditure profile 1, expenditure profile 2, receipts budget, budget at glance, highlights. If you are preparing your budget for exams, my dear friend, kindly, if you are not able to prepare total budget, just read this, highlights of the budget and budget at glance. These two things will provide you a clear idea of budget. In our class also, in our channel also, in future I will be taking class on this also, budget at glance or highlights of the budget, because July 5th we are going to have our new budget, no issues. Next, what is interim budget? Here comes the interim budget. Many get confused this with vote on account. Now you know what is vote on account. So don't confuse it with interim budget. Interim budget means what? Now, the election is conducted on 2019, you know. So before the election, if you are having a full year budget, now the government collapses, there is an issue. So interim budget means you must be having a budget during the election time. See, during an election time, you cannot change major taxes. If you are bringing a major taxes and major changes, so then obviously your government will be manipulating the election. So in order to reduce the manipulation in the election, the interim budget is provided. In the interim budget, you have total expenditure and total receipts. Everything is similar to the fiscal budget, sorry, a normal general budget, but interim budget is for a short span of time. Here, to avoid major changes in income tax laws and these things, we'll be having only little changes. This is what we had understood of interim budget. This is similar to a normal budget, but during the election year, in order to reduce the major changes, they introduce interim budget as a small budget. Now we can see here, my dear friends, whatever the details of the our India's budget. Here, our independent India. When was the first budget introduced in independent India? It was introduced November 26, 1947. And who has introduced it? That is much more important for you. He is called as R.K. Shanmugam Chetty. He is the one after independence, first budget has been released by him. And also, who had released more budgets in India? Morarji Desai. These are all simple facts that will not be helpful for UPSC exam, but small exam, if you are preparing, this helps you a lot. So that only I am providing this, my dear friend. Here you can see Morarji Desai had introduced a maximum number of budgets, that is 10 times. And also, you want to know when is the first budget introduced in India? It is in 1869, my dear friend, in February 18, yeah, 1869, February 18. This is the date our first budget was released. This was released by Mr. James Wilson. So you know who is James Wilson? He will be a Britisher, so no issues, whoever he is. So he was the first person to introduce the budget. Now, one more thing you must remember. First 5 years after the budget until 1955, I think so, the budget was printed in only English. Later it was translated and printed in both languages like Hindi and English. Now what I'm saying is just a fact that may be required for your exam, may or may not be required, nothing issues. And next you can see here, the budget is announced what time? It is customary of British that 5 p.m. they release the budget. So but India till 1999 we were following. After that we changed the sense of following. So we started introducing our budget by 11 a.m. Why do they introduce the evening means? Because you will be having whole night, so that you will close all the accounts and next day you will be starting having a fresh start. So that only they used to have by 5 p.m. But now that is also changed to 11 a.m. So now present our budget will be released by 11 a.m. And we know our budget will be announced by February 1st. And also now recently few things you get confused, my dear friend. One thing is that we are having CEO who is on Nirmala Sitharaman. She is the first female finance minister. It is given that, but remember one thing, first female finance minister is Indira Gandhi. So Indira Gandhi is a PM plus finance minister, first person to hold prime ministry post and finance ministry post, and she is the first prime minister to introduce the budget also. And also now Nirmala Sitharaman is a individual, so some exams they will be confuse you and ask, so be clarity. Nirmala Sitharaman is the first individual finance minister, but first woman finance minister is Indira Gandhi, so never get confused. Next, halwa ceremony. You can see here our finance minister is distributing halwa in the cup to the all the persons. That is what happened at 10 days before the budget, a week or 10 days before the budget, the budget papers will be printed. So in order to print the budget papers, they need a secure location, so they will be secretly printing, so that their mobile phones, everything will be switched off and no connections will be provided. They will be secretly present. So before that work starts, the 10 days before the budget, it is customary as usual, now all the officers and supporting staff in the finance minister, the finance minister serves halwa to everyone. So that is our tradition, you know, Indian tradition, to do any important work we just have sweets before doing any important work. That is the thing, they use this halwa ceremony so that they taste the sweet and start the work of printing budget papers. So these documents are much more precious and much more secretly maintained, so they are kept in a basement of Northern Block. So all the person, those who are working in this document, they are locked up there, so they will be in a basement of Northern Block secretly, and nobody will be coming out, so external contacts will be curtailed. So they will be preparing secretly our budget, and finally our finance minister takes that budget and presents in our parliament. This is what related to all the details that needed for your budget, my dear friends. Okay, this is SPV Education. Together we create a better world. If you're not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel. Okay, friends, this is me, SP Rajan, taking you classes in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. So just better don't get confused. Watch our playlist so that it helps you a lot to your learning. Okay, friends, this is me, SP Rajan, taking your classes. If you like our classes and you need to support me economically and for the development of our channel, and really you pay lakhs to the institute, but I provide for free. But thing is that if I want to provide a much more and more rural students, some persons capable to help, you can help, my dear friend. So you can crowdfund through Tez or Paytm, so that we can together create a better world and teach much more precious and important things to the value of UPSC and Group 1 standard. Thank you, friends. Those who are already subscribed and supporting, thank you. Thanks a lot. It means a lot by your support, by signing off SP Rajan.